And now we have all the consent forms signed. Just give us some time to let the anesthesia team know and the nursing team know so that we can get prepared to move to the OR.
All right, so we'll just take a few minutes. We'll just get everything organized. All right, we're gonna bring in another stretcher, get you moved over, get everything set up in the OR, okay? All right, I'll call that for that.
Help you.
Hi, we've made a decision to go to the OR with this patient, so I'm going to need someone to bring me a stretcher as well as a hat and mask for my patient, please.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hat and mask, thank you so much, Mel.
Welcome.
All right. Turn that off. Okay, so we're gonna get you to come over here onto this stretcher, okay? So just a little bit at a time. Okay, Dr. Cooke will help from the other side. Maybe if you take the PT on the other side.
Oh,
she
yeah.
Still has some movement, so
okay.
There we go.
Right.
Over, good. Awesome, that's it. Just bring your legs a little bit. Good job, almost there.
Okay, I'm gonna go get ready for the OR and we will call you guys when we're ready for you.
Perfect.
Okay.
You are going to have to wear a mask, okay, when we take you to the OR, but we'll wait until we're ready to leave before I put that on, okay?
Hi, I'm ready for you in the OR. You can transfer.
Okay, let me just put her mask on. Okay. All right. Very good. Perfect. All right. It's gonna be okay, all right? We're all ready to get back there. Okay.
Healthy, very reassuring.
Okay.
I'm gonna put some monitors on you, okay?
need to brush her. All right, so if you can just stand her, if you can just help me get a little bit. All right, so we're just going to put that pump back into your hand. Yes, okay? There we go. Perfect. Good.
You and Gerry might have to their old top up. Get set up for our conversion to GA. I'm dirty, you're clean, Purnima, so I want you to grab the GA C-section kit and the glass.
Okay, we'll do that.
We are going to be doing a rapid sequence induction. Purnima is going to be giving the drugs. We are going to keep this mask on, not the other one. I'm not going to bag. She will desaturate, okay, so I just want to let you anticipate that. When the tube is in place, Sandra, I want you to inflate this cuff all the way. When it is inflated, we will connect, make sure everything's tight. We'll confirm we're in, and then I will tell you, Emmy, start surgery. Anyone have any questions?
No.
Can I just confirm everyone has the appropriate PPE on? With the
red
flags.
Okay. So we will start our induction. We're quiet in the room, please.
Ready for me to go?
Yes, please.
120 of Garofalo again.
I'll get the two from you, please. All the way up, please. Okay, insert the cup all the way.
So I will take that from you. Thank you.
Bring it to the circle, please. Pull the tube. Circuit is connected. Blue filter is tight. Can you start bagging, please?
So bagging, I have an entitled
CO2. Okay, you can start surgery.
Start time.
So I'm not waking her up until you guys have to stop.
Okay.
I've left the room. And I'll slowly wake her up and avoid coughing. So we'll do something on our end to do that. And then we're going to extubate her and wait for an hour here.
Okay. We will be around. Step one, remove glove. Using one hand, grasp inner wrist of glove on opposite hand. Hold glove while turning it inside out. Using the removed glove, which is now inside out, grasp the wrist of the remaining glove. Pull glove off while turning it inside out. Place glove in the waste container.
We're going to have to do the same for our second set of gloves now. And before we turn, take our gown off, I think we'll add some hand hygiene here.
Step two, remove your gown. Important, avoid touching the outside of your gown with your hand. Do not allow the gown to fall onto the floor, hitting your leg. Remove with control. Starting at the waist, untie the back of your gown. Next, untie necktie. Pull them forward so the gown is hanging off your shoulders, then drop the ties in front of you. Use a finger of one hand to hook inside the cuff of your opposite wrist and pull the sleeve until your hand is just inside the cuff. With your hand still inside the cuff, grasp the cuff of your opposite wrist and pull the sleeve about halfway off. While removing your arms from the sleeves, carefully roll the gown inside, ensuring the sleeves are rolled up into the body of the gown. Place the rolled up gown into the waist container. Now perform hand hygiene. Step four, remove eye protection, your face shield. Face shield first, lean forward at the waist with your chin pointing out. Using both hands, reach behind your head. Grasp under the elastic band, pull the elastic band over your head, and pull the face shield away from your face. Put the face shield in the waist container. Step five, remove your cap. Using both hands, reach behind your neck, grasp under the elastic, pull the cap, and place the cap in the waist container. Step six, remove your N95 mask outside of the patient room.
Okay, so we'll go outside and we will use the docking instructions outside to do that.
To extubate, everyone has left the room. We've optimized our patient. We are still wearing our N95s and our full PPE. Things are going to be a bit different. I'm going to put this plastic bag over the patient's face through this whole process as a barrier to you and me. When we extubate, we are going to deflate the tube, and then the tube and the blue filter are going to go in our bin. So I will do that while you put the non-rebreather mask on the patient's face under the bag, and then this face mask with elastics goes on top. Does that make sense? All right. Okay, so you can deflate the cuff. Perfect. And then you can get the non-rebreather.